Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're going to make a summer fruit bowl. And it's basically fruit. I've chosen to use frozen fruit. So all you need to do is get to a store that is large enough to carry items like this, but usually in average size towns and above, you can find them very easily. I'm going to show you some things that I purchased, and there are 8 different fruits involved in this fruit bowl that I'm making. Here we have frozen blueberries. You can see it isn't unopened. It is in open, so I could use it, but otherwise it was unopened, and that's how many you get. Here we have sliced strawberries. Again, quite a lot of those. Here we have 3 kinds of fruits. We have blueberries, which is a repetition of what I have here, so I don't have to go from both bags, but I will get blueberries from one or the other. Also raspberries and blackberries. Here we have cherries, dark sweet cherries. Here we have mango chunks. Those look delicious. And then some I took out of bags and put into measuring cups or clear containers. So over here we have red and green grapes. I'm counting them as separate entities because they look so different. And below that we have our mango chunks. So we'll be putting that in together. And here we have blackberries, blueberries, and raspberries, and on top there are some strawberries. So I think I've given the name of all of the fruits that are going in here. Each is going in 1 cup size. So these have been measured out, so there would be 1 cup of every flavor that you see in front of me. So let's get these out of the way. And I might not pour all of them at some point because I might think that they would sink to the bottom, and I want this to look really pretty. So we'll just get an assortment that comes out of this measuring cup, and then an assortment over here. The easy thing to remember is that we're using all of what we measured. We don't measure as we put it in. We measure 1 cup of each item to be used, and then that's what we put in. And here we have more fruit. That's really that nice. And nice colorful fruit here. And fruit is healthy. I didn't pick it for that reason. I picked it because I think it's just a really attractive dish, and also I like the fruits. There could be a fruit or two that is not my favorite, but when they're put in a bowl like this and displayed, they just have a greater appeal. So here is the bowl that contains all the fruit that I've been working with. And you can see it comes up to the top and even mounds up a little bit. So it would be almost impossible for me to stir it in that form. I'm going to put it in a larger bowl. And I can always bring it back to this decorative bowl to serve if I like. But I have a much better chance of getting some variety here in each person's serving if I have room to stir it around. So just pour that into a bigger bowl and then use something. I have a slotted spoon here to stir. And you can see now it's easily stirred and mixed around. And when you get your serving, it won't be all one thing or one or two things. It will be a variety of things. Speaking of serving, I have a sherbet glass here that I'm going to use. And that's just for looks and for a fancy meal. This is something you might serve in that meal and you would want it to look wonderful. So here we have all of our fruit in the large bowl, and I'm going to serve it in this sherbet dish. So I'm just going to spoon out an assortment, and I can control where I see in the bowl the items that I want. So if I'm getting a lot of grapes, for example, if I like grapes, that's fine. But in general, you want to make it as diverse as possible. So you're going to expect your bowl of fruit to look something like this. I'll stop right there. Now, what makes this particular recipe really special is that I give it a topping. And the topping I have chosen, in order to keep it reasonably healthy, I don't want to add a bunch of sugar on top or caramel or brown sugar or anything like that. I've chosen Crystal Light, and the flavor I've chosen is Cherry Pomegranate. When you use perhaps a package per large bowl, or you might want to use more than that, I would suggest that you apply it after you have the fruit in your serving dish. And then you can apply it fairly evenly over the top. And if you really love this stuff, then just go after it, put a lot. It looks like that. This should be served at the time you serve your whole dinner, including the entree. And when a person gets ready to eat this, the fruit will have melted enough from the icy crystals that it has now. It will have melted enough that it can be eaten easily. And also some of that powder will mix with the moisture that's in this, and it will be a little syrupy and a nice topping. So I'm going to take a bite of this and see how that topping tastes. I'll take just a small grape, but I do see the topping on it. So here we go. It is delicious. The fact that the fruit is frozen just adds to the flavor and everything about it. I think you'll enjoy this just for yourself and your family at home, or for a nice meal that you want to look really fancy and really pretty, but you want to keep it easy, and you can find the things very easily that you need to put together. Enjoy!